I spoke with Tori Wilson, a sophomore who was in the third to the last row on that bus. She explained the junior high band director kept running onto the burning bus, grabbing students and pulling them to safety. Tori had to hoist herself through a window to safety.
And then someone said, you know, something about a fire and, you know, this is an emergency, like, we got to get out of here. And I was, like, struggling because I couldn't move from, like, because I was stuck. And I had a kid, like, over top me having a seizure and not moving, you know, unresponsive. I had my friend beside me to my right that was sitting right to where I was going to sit, but she said that, you know, I could have the inside towards the window. And all I could see was her head, and the rest was all crushed underneath seats. And the kid behind me, because there was three seats behind me, because it went two, and then the very last row had three. The kid behind me was complaining his legs, and I was trying to get out, but, like, I didn't want to crush him, because, you know, anytime I moved, the seats moved, because I was trying to get out. And, you know, then you start, like, you know, screaming in pain, and then one of the kid that was on the far right of the three, he was in the middle of the aisle and not moving.
And Tori's mom tells me she's just relieved that both of her children who are on that bus are okay. But she tells me her heart absolutely goes out to all of the families who have been impacted by this crash.